Hi everyone, this is Billy. I'm now testing with a long antenna, my horn speaker, and the two crystal radio that I printed using my 3D printer. So let's take a look. Hi ladies and gentlemen, this is Billy. Tonight I took out all my crystal radios that I made in these few weeks, all the 3D printed ones, and all my 3D printed sound modules for the gramophone speaker. And let's do a testing. I would pull a long antenna, 15 meter long, to receive the radio station from a transmission station around 5 kilometers away from me on an island transmitter that is from the sea, just outside my apartment. So I'm able to get around 300 microampere of after detection DC current. This is enough to drive the speaker. I will also test with the LED as a detector, so it will light up as well as detect and give you the music. Thanks for watching. If you like my video, click like, subscribe, and share with your friends too. Thank you. I'm testing today without amplifier. So the output of the crystal radio that I test is connected directly through this transformer, step-down transformer, to this gramophone speaker that I just created. There's a driver unit inside that is the normal horn speaker's driver unit. It's just a speaker, a treble speaker. So we are able to hear it directly because I got a strong signal. The after detection DC current goes above 300 microampere sometimes. Now I'm changing to this other sound unit. It's just a telephone handset mouthpiece. We bought this from the China Taobao.com. Let me adjust my audio transformer to match the 350 ohm of the speaker. So this is the antenna tuner. Let me tune it. And this one is the crystal radio. I'm using a crystal here. Not a crystal, a dial here. So one of these dials. I think it will get a much louder voice if I can run two in parallel. Right now we are getting around 150 microampere. So even though the meter says 15 or 17, well, actually I've connected a parallel resistor to extend the range to 10 times. So it's now 160 microampere. Now I tune to this very loud station, 300 milli microampere. But I can't do it for long because YouTube will say there's a copyright claim if I play that copyrighted music for more than 10 seconds. So I can only flip it for a second and then come back like that. Apologies about that. All this Chinese opera music has no copyright, so I can play it as long as I need for testing. So this is my sound unit. This is a 300 ohm mouthpiece from a telephone handset. I put it in my 3D design sandbox and then put in my horn speaker to enlarge it physically. As you can hear, with this it will be much louder. Without this, it's not as loud. Let me switch to another sound unit. That's the horn speaker driver. It's the 8-ohm driver. Let me put in the horn speaker. You see, it's very obvious. With the horn speaker, the sound is much louder. Let me flip to the loud station for a while, for a bit. This is my impedance matching transformer. On the input, I tune it to 1.5k. Okay, let me try to tune it to 5k and see what happens. You can tune it to different value and see which one is louder. Is around 2.5k. And let's try to change it to a 3DQ and see if the output will be louder or the same. Let me plug in this 3DQ. Here's my 3DQ. Okay, here's my 3DQ. Let me plug it in. Wow, once I plug it into 3DQ, the output changed to around 300 microampere. So the 3DQ is really doing a nice job enlarging the signal. Let me try to flip to the loud station and see what happens.
still around 300 microampere. A bit overload. It's a bit cracky. That's the reason why 3DQ is only good for weak signal detection. Hi, I'm testing the LED as a detector. This is an LED. It's a super light LED, not the regular ones. Only the super light LED can show such a brightness. So if I turn it away, no station, LED will dim. But if I turn to a station, the LED will light up. I change back to the diode and I switch to a different crystal radio, the flat one, and let's see, the current is 200 microampere now. So if we change it to an LED and see what happens. Dead silence, and the microampere changed to zero. Because in 200 microampere is still not enough to drive an LED. So let's try again. Now we switch to a different station, 350 microampere. We just changed to the LED. See the LED is lighting up. And then the microampere changed to 1 microampere. Not 1 micro, 10 microampere.